So like any other theory of intelligence, case-based reasoning has some assumptions. The first assumption is that there are patterns to the problems that agents encounter in the world. The same kinds of problems tend to reoccur again and again. A lot of science is about finding patterns of regularity in the world. Physics finds patterns of regularity in the world that are expressed by various kinds of laws, like Newton's second law of motion. Presumably, if you're going to build a theory of intelligence, that theory too will give an account of what kind of patterns exist in the world that mind, that intelligence must encounter. And case-based reasoning says one of the common patterns is that the same kinds of problems occur again and again and again. So that's the first assumption. Second assumption is that similar problems often have similar solutions. Here is a grid of a part of Long Island. Here is a grid of part of Dallas, Texas. Now, if you look at the one in Long Island, you can see that if there are two problems which are very close to each other, they're likely to have very similar solutions. And the same is true for the grid in Dallas. Similarly, the second assumption is not always valid. Here is an example of it. I'm sure all of you know how to tie your shoelaces. But imagine that you buy a new pair of shoes, and this new pair of shoes has Velcro straps. Now the problem is very similar, how to tighten your shoes, but the solution is radically different.
So Ashok, another example of this that comes to mind for me is the example of touchscreens. Some of the early touchscreens could only handle one touch at a time. If you touched it with two fingers at a time, it either wouldn't register or would only register one of the touches. Current touchscreens on smartphones and tablets that we use today can handle two or three or four fingers at a time. The problem is very similar. We're still touching a screen and interacting with it with our fingers, but the solution is actually very, very different. It uses a completely different kind of technology, different material for the screen, and a different way of detecting where the screen is being touched.
That's a good example, David. So we have at least two examples now where similar problems can have quite different solutions. Nevertheless, this assumption is valid most of the time. Most of the time, two problems that are quite similar will end up having two solutions that are quite similar as well.